Very good evening to all of you here. I'm so excited. After 2 years, I'm entering an auditorium, a physical auditorium, of course. We've been having lots and lots of talks, probably 3-4 a day, but in the virtual space. So after hearing both the speakers, I think it has also inspired me. I'm sure all of you are feeling inspired. Are you? Yes? Yeah. So let's give it up for these two guys. A 30-year-old man every morning would get out of his house and lock his door and keep counting. Every time he locked the door, he kept counting. He had to count up to 60. He had to check if the lock was locked 60 times. And every time he did that, a group of kids would come and interrupt him. So if he would say 34, 35, 36, they would come and say, "Hi, what are you doing?" And then he had to start counting all over again. And they kept doing that. And while he did that, and these kids made a lot of fun of him, a 6-year-old girl watched him and wondered what was happening and why the kids were making so much fun of him. She went up to her mother and asked, "Mom, what's his problem?" And the mom said that he is not well. So if he is not well, why is he all by himself? Why is he not going to the doctor, and why is he not becoming all right? She said, because the family has deserted him. They do not understand what is happening to him. That was 50 years ago. And today I stand asking you the same question. Yes, that 6-year-old child was me, wondering why is there a stigma towards mental health and towards mental illness. And the reason I'm here is because I want all of you to join the anti-stigma campaign against mental health issues. I'm not here to talk about my courage or to talk about my story. I'm here to share with you stories of each and every person who struggles with mental health issues. Yes, that is true. In the last 5 years, suicide has doubled in our country. When I authored the book, That Is Not the Answer, there were 16 suicides happening in India. Today, the rate is 34. And since the last 50 years, I'm only trying to do one thing, and I do it every single day of my life, that is get up in the morning and find every opportunity to make people understand that yes, mental health is real, and there is no health without mental health. When I wanted to take up my career of psychiatry, you know, there were doctors who came home and told my parents why I should not take up psychiatry, because the stigma that time was that we have heard that psychiatrists themselves they go mad after a few years. Here I am, 30 years in the practice in front of you, and I want you to declare me fit. The other stigma was, as a kabaddi player was saying, "Koi isse shaadi nahi karega." Okay, pagalo ki doctor hai, khud pagal ho jayegi, who will marry her? Ab kya kar rahe ho? Please do not allow her to take up this field. But I'm thankful to my parents that they believed in me then and they believe in me now. And it is those same people who told them that please do not allow her to follow her passion. These are the same people who come and tell me today that, you know, what you're doing is absolutely, you know, right, because this is what is required. Yes, of course, there was struggle. I remember going to a school because there was a girl who was referred to me. The girl would run away from her school every day, and she jumped walls. She was put in a boarding school. She tried to cut herself, and she did all these things till, you know, the parents found a school for her, and she just refused to go there. And then what happened was, you know, as our schools do, a leaving certificate was sent to our house. And the parents approached me and said, we don't know what to do with her. I said, let me go and meet the principal of the school. I remember going to the school, and the principal did not even allow me to enter her office. She says, Dr. Chhabria, we don't have any psychos in our school. Please go away. I said, ma'am, can I just meet you for 1 second? You know, and she says, okay. She kept sitting there. I kept standing in front of her. And I just appealed to her heart and just asked her one question. Ma'am, if she was your daughter, would you do anything differently? You know, so she said, what do you want me to do? I don't have time for all this. I said, ma'am, if you can just start having breakfast with her every day, because the child has eating disorders, she has depression, she has lots of things. But of course, the principal did not have the time to listen to all this. And yes, today that kid is probably 40 years old. She's just got married. She owns a couple of restaurants, very popular ones in our city. It was just because that one person cared enough for her to help her cross through. Another story to share with you, when I just started practice, and I was, we doctors apply to hospitals thinking ki chalo hospital se patients milenge. And I went, I reached the final round of interviews, and the panel sat there and they says, oh, you're so tiny. How are you going to be able to handle psychiatric patients? So we're very sorry, but we have decided to take a male who was apparently a bodybuilder. So I said, but if you were looking for bodybuilders, why did you even ask for psychiatrists? You all should have just said that we want bodybuilders, right? Because the whole trick is to be sitting over here and convincing people. We are not here. We are not wrestlers. This was the stigma 25 years ago. And yes, coming to today, I am so thankful that COVID happened, because it is only thanks to COVID that finally people are recognizing what is mental health, what are the issues that can happen if there are mental health issues. 6 years ago, when I authored the book Death Is Not the Answer, and I realized the statistics of suicide. I'm sure all you learned guys have heard about farmer suicides. But if I tell you that 25 times more housewives commit suicide than farmers, a lot of us think that children don't suffer from mental health issues. The youngest suicide attempt I have seen is of a 6-year-old. And that 6-year-old took an overdose of tablets, and she fooled everybody. And she said, maine meethi goli samajh ke kha li. A little scratch. I spent some time with her, and she said that, you know, nobody loves me, so it's better if I die. Yes, she really wanted to kill herself. Suicide can happen with children. It can happen with old people as well. And since the last 6 years, I have been appealing to every adult I know, to every youngster I know. There are only 7,000 psychiatrists in India. We cannot wage this war alone. We need the support. We need all you guys sitting right here, and all those who are listening to and will listen to this, to become mental health ambassadors, because it is so easy to help someone who's suffering from a mental health condition. The problem is we do not know what to do. So today, if I get a heart attack standing right here, all of you will be fighting on which hospital to take me to. Someone will say, let's go here, let's go there, because all of you know what you're supposed to do. But if I go out of this room and I say, you know what, I'm feeling suicidal, all of you will want to run away and not know what to do, because you will say that, you know, oh my God, what do I tell her? She's feeling suicidal. And the next thing will happen is you will start gossiping with each other and say, oh my God, she looks absolutely fine. Why is she suicidal? That is the stigma of mental health issues. Just because people look fine does not mean that they're fine. And we need together to encourage mental health conversations. We also need, if tomorrow a friend tells you that, you know what, I don't feel like living, man, this COVID has really affected me, what I want you to do is reach out to that person. Do not gossip about the person. How do you reach out? Simple. Just ask them, what happened? You made that statement. I was a little concerned about you. If possible, yes, meet them one-on-one without looking at your phone, without getting distracted. Listen to their story. And at the end of that, please do not give free advice. That is something we are all experts in doing. In fact, ask them, I want to help you. How can I help you? Most of the time, you may just hear that, you know, just talking to you is such a relief. But yes, if the person, tell the person that, no, I have heard that this could be a mental health condition and let's meet a professional. No, I don't want to go anywhere. They give medicines. These are the myths which surround us, that all psychiatrists are waiting for you to go into the chamber so that they'll catch you, they'll give you electric shocks, and they'll give you medicines which are going to make you sleep for the rest of your life. This is a misconception and this is a myth. And we need the intelligent people around here, this, all of you, to break these myths and misconceptions. Gone are the days where people would give ECTs and people would give lots and lots of medicines. Today, if the doctor thinks, yes, there could be, just as you take a medicine for diabetes, if you have a serotonin imbalance, if you have a dopamine imbalance and you need to take a tablet, go ahead and take it. So I want you all to join this mental health revolution with me. I'm here to appeal to each one of you to become a mental health ambassador, so that together we can reduce the mental health stigma around us, so that together we can help people who are suffering, because everybody suffers from mental health issues. Your grandmother at home, when she says, I don't feel like living, don't think, oh my God, she's already 85, why should she live? No, she has a right to be happy. She has a right to live properly, and ask her what's happening. Oh, I'm not getting sleep. Do not give her a tablet to sleep. Do not prescribe medicines yourself. Instead, say, let's talk to a psychiatrist. Maybe this is a problem that can be solved. Your father today, if he complains about how the COVID has hit him financially, and how he does not feel like waking up in the morning, and how he's not able to sleep, and that's why he's drinking alcohol, do not justify that behavior. Instead, tell him, let's meet somebody. I'm sure everybody who's been hit financially is not drinking alcohol or popping pills. Why is it that you're thinking this way? His chemicals are different and he's gone into a depression. And yes, it is only about chemicals, neurochemicals. Do not suggest that let's go for a holiday and all your depression will go away. Imagine if you are feeling depressed and someone says, oh, go for a holiday, everything will become all right. It's not going to become all right. It's probably going to get worse when you come back. So let's be smart. Let's join this entire journey, because yes, there was stigma 50 years ago. There still is stigma. But together, I am sure and hopeful that together with the help of all you bright minds here, we are going to make a difference.